Well, let's get more on our top story now. The Friends of Syria conference that's underway in Istanbul. Joining me from London now is Michael Weiss. He's communications director at the UK-based think tank, the Henry Jackson Society. Michael, thanks for joining the programme. This is the second conference for the Friends of Syria. There's clearly some division amongst the delegates as to exactly what should be being done there. Do you think this meeting can achieve anything concrete?
I don't think it can achieve anything concrete, unfortunately, at this point. There seems to be too much international division over Syria. Russia, China, and Iran, which are still backing the Assad regime, for instance, are not going to this conference. And, you know, it seems as though the United States and most of the Arab countries are now still pushing the Kofi Annan plan, or at least trying to give it a chance to work. Although confidence for that plan being achievable in any way, shape, or form is very low. I mean, for instance, yesterday, I think 65 people were killed. The day before, 80 people were killed in Syria. So I think this is, you know, it's more sort of to market the perception of the Syrian opposition becoming more united and cohesive. But whether or not anything is going to be, you know, put forward from this, it remains to be seen.
Well, the Syrian National Council says that it is becoming more united. It's presenting a united front. The difficulty seems to be that they themselves aren't sure exactly what to call for, although there are calls coming out from within Syria for buffer zones, for example, or military intervention.
Yeah. I think, well, for them, I mean, they would like this sort of maximalist solution of military intervention led by the United States, actually materially led by Turkey, which has been threatening to impose a buffer zone since last June. So I think actually they've been quite consistent in calling for that. The problem is there's no will on the part of any country, European, American, otherwise, to do anything like this. Another problem, though, you mentioned that sort of the cohesiveness of the opposition, the Syrian Kurds have essentially repudiated the Syrian National Council because they feel as though their demands for Kurdish cultural rights and autonomous zone in northeastern Syria have not been met. Now, Syria's Kurds represent between 10% to 15% of the Syrian population. Without them being fully on board in terms of supporting the revolution but also joining with the SNC, it really is a mystery as to how this thing can be won. So without sort of uniting these minority groups, the Kurdish minority group, I would call the decisive minority of Syria, the Syrian National Council has its work cut out for it.
Mm. It's evident that there's a lot of frustration amongst delegates that nothing's been achieved thus far. The Qatari Prime Minister, for example, saying, look, we have to implement a timeline. And he talks about President Bashar al-Assad's time wasting. Assad has been very successful, hasn't he, in delaying implementing anything that he agrees to.
Absolutely. I mean, he gets everything he wants, doesn't he? Every time there's some diplomatic protocol, which the United States coyly refers to exhausting all the diplomatic options, it gives him more time to maneuver and kill people. Scores have been killed already since the government nominally accepted the Annan protocol. I just saw in my news feed before coming to the studio that Syria describes the Friends of Syria conference as its own way to try and kill Syrian people. So the regime is using the language of propaganda. It's using the language of a united international conspiracy against itself. In the same breath, saying that, oh, no, no, we would agree with Kofi Annan in principle, and we're going to do everything we can to remove the tanks from the streets, but only until, or not until, rather, we have cleansed Syria of all its terrorists. So, I mean, anybody who puts faith in this regime to do anything substantive or to back down, I think, is living in a fantasy.
Mm. It's another depressing picture out of Syria. Thank you very much indeed, Michael.
Indeed.
Appreciate your comments.
Sure.
Michael Weiss there from the Henry Jackson Society.
Thank you.